I'm at the site of the Battle of Tippecanoe, November 7th, 1811, says. This is where the world changed. Walking through the gate. Let's see what's going on over here. There's some snowmen. More than one. There's the spot. It's a big memorial to Harrison. You can see up his big nose.
So what is this? I noticed it when I got out of the ghost.
Oh man. So it lists all the officers killed, you know, they get their own section. And then over here, here's just the regular guys who were killed. Anybody related to you? Where the battle actually happened. You see little grave markers here and there out there. A lot of monuments and signs. Remembering the white people who died here. But none remembering the natives. In fact, all it says about the Native Americans who died here is that an unknown number of them died here. That doesn't really seem fair. Here's the famous river, the Tippecanoe River. Should we go up on the bridge? Let's do it. The kids will want to go up on the bridge. I'll probably show this to them tomorrow. It'll be one day turnaround. The Indian village would have been around here, where the prophet had his headquarters, right on the river. Be careful on that ice. Oh, it's just slush. Think of all the blood over this land. The thought that they have a monument to the man who did the killing and not any mention.
Well, they do mention Indian loss unknown.
Oh, let's take a look.
That's it.
That's as much as they're gonna get. And that's such an important part of what happened here. It was like the last chance. Huh. So we got a little sign here. Somebody just put some thumbtacks up. It's a great quote from Harrison. The bark was flying from trees. The Indians had the best powder and bullets as well as the bow and arrow. They fought on till daylight came. At the southern end of the battlefield, the Indian took his last stand. He will only